Once you've configured your Azure SQL database or SQL Manage instance, the next thing you might think about is how you're going to get data in there. There are a lot of options available, and some of these might look familiar to you. For example, you can use BCP, and this is going to allow you to connect to Azure SQL from on-prem or to connect to Azure SQL from an Azure virtual machine. You can also use things like bulk insert, except instead of pointing from on-prem files, you're pointing from something like Azure Blob Storage. There are various options available. One that you might not have known is that you can actually use Spark connectors to connect to Azure SQL database. You can also, using the portal, create copies of your database using database copy, and this is also supported in some of the CLI options. The last point I wanted to mention is that in Managed Instance, you can actually restore a database natively from a URL. Now, these are just some of the options, but there are some various things you need to consider when you're choosing which option and choosing how to load data.
Yeah, Anna just mentioned the fact that you could use bulk insert as a T-SQL option with Azure SQL, but if you think about it, you don't have access to the file system like you do on your servers, so you would be using Azure Blob Storage as a URL in those cases, and we fully support that. But also just consider the fact that it's going to be much more efficient for you to load your files into Azure Blob Storage using various tools Azure provides. It's much more fast, much more seamless. And of course, you might want to keep these files in Azure Blob Storage for other purposes and a repetitive mode of trying to maybe do ETL jobs and so forth. Now, keep in mind a couple things. Minimum logging is not supported for bulk operations. We only support full recovery. So you got to keep that in mind as far as the way you load data and the methods you load data. And in fact, you might be affected by transaction log governance that we do specifically in the Azure ecosystem as you're doing a lot of loading of data, which is why things like batch sizes for bulk copies can become very important for you to consider as you're doing a plan to maybe say do like a bulk import of type data. And then if you've seen column store indexes, specifically clustered column store indexes, that can be a much more efficient option for loading data. And in some cases, if column store is the right choice for you, can avoid some of these governance and transaction log modes. So we've covered some of the options of loading data in Azure SQL, whether it's popular programs you've used like BCP, using bulk insert, using SSIS, even the new Azure Data Factory. And I mentioned about Spark connectors. Keep in mind, you can do database copies. You can also do restores with Managed Instance from a database that you've backed up with copy only. And keep in mind those special properties of doing, especially like doing bulk import scenarios, to make sure you're using the right batch size to avoid governance problems and to be more efficient by using Azure Storage as maybe a place where you're keeping a lot of your native files and then use that as your central repository to go do loading your data into Azure. I hope you've enjoyed this brief video talking about loading data and look forward to talking to you in the next video.